Continue to follow breaking news at Sacramento State. An officer opened fire inside a dorm room on campus after a deadly attack.
We have team coverage on the campus attack and that shooting. We're starting right now with KCRA3's Damani Lewis. Damani.
Well, Galston school leaders just held a news conference about a half an hour ago. Tonight, the president of Sacramento State confirmed that a homicide did happen here on the campus. He addressed that, as well as the police chief addressed public safety here on campus. Here's what they had to say.
Another person was found at the scene with injuries. That person later died at the hospital.
What can you say to parents tonight, obviously, who are wondering about the safety on the campus of Sac State?
I can tell you that this was an isolated altercation that took place between two individuals. One of those is in custody in the hospital, and the other one unfortunately passed away. And it was an isolated incident, and the campus is safe.
Now, for students, many of them are still trying to take all of this in. They heard the gunshot, saw the hectic scene, and for many of them, they just can't believe what just happened.
I hear a pop pop.
Shots fired in a Sacramento State dorm. It happened just after 2. Sac State investigators say they responded to a disturbance here at the American River Courtyard Dormitory. Police say they walked into a room and found a victim possibly beaten with a bat and a suspect holding a knife. Moments later, police say the suspect charged at them.
So there was a scuffle, and then I heard them tell him to get back down on the ground. I heard the air, like the pistol, not the actual shots, but the Nerf gun, I guess it would be.
Taser?
Yeah. Well, no, it wasn't a taser. It was like a Nerf gun or like a beanbag gun or something like that go off, and then I heard the shots go off.
A Nerf gun by the student inside, maybe?
Or I have no idea. I couldn't see that part. All I could see was the broken window.
Within 10 seconds, 2 shots went off. And then 2 more gunshots went off.
2 people were taken to the hospital. So far, police say they don't have a motive for the incident. 2 hours after the shooting, the dormitory was reopened to students. But many are left to wonder what happened.
I just hope everybody's okay.
And students will be allowed to go back into the dormitory, especially in that area where this incident happens, within the next half an hour to an hour. Now, it's also important to note that police tell us the night before they shot the suspect, they used what they call a pepper gun to subdue the suspect. That did not work. And then that's when investigators say they were forced, they had to use their weapons in this incident. And for students who do not want to go back in their dorm this evening, school leaders tell us moments ago that they are trying to provide assistance for them to live somewhere else this evening. Galston, Edie, back to you.
All right, Damani, thank you. And we continue our team coverage of the story with KCRA3's Kevin Riggs, who's been talking to students. Kev?
Edie, that's right. As you might expect, a lot of concern expressed by students here this afternoon at this sudden eruption of violence on the Sacramento State campus. As Damani mentioned, any students who were inside the dorm you see here behind me were evacuated after that shooting, and they remained outside the building for a number of hours, wandering around, muddling around, waiting to see what was going to happen and waiting for firm information on what happened. The campus police did not put out a general notice about what happened immediately because they said they felt the situation was contained and was not widespread. In any case, it was a scene of confusion here this afternoon. We talked to students about that.
I would never thought it would happen at a place like this, so it's kind of shocking.
Make you worry a little bit about your own whereabouts and your own safety?
Not my own safety. Like, I think I'm still pretty safe because this is kind of like something that doesn't really happen all the time.
I think it's just random, but I leave my window shut and my door locked when I'm not there, like, just in case. Like, I'm not going to, I have a laptop in my room, I don't want anything getting stolen.
It's scary because it could happen to anybody, so when it happens to, like, your friends and your surroundings, and it's like, well, you really think about it could happen to you anytime, and you just got to be careful and be aware of your surroundings at all times.
I really just came here not really knowing what was going on. And
so here you are waiting.
Yep. Wondering how long it's going to be. I don't really have anything on me, so I want to get inside.
What did you think when you heard about what happened?
I was surprised.
And that was clearly a common sentiment here today. I talked to one student who actually lives in the dorm room complex where the violence took place. He said he was unaware of any kind of tension or any kind of problem that was brewing prior to this violence actually breaking out. Now, any students who are actually living in and around where the attack took place will be moved to temporary housing tonight and possibly will be allowed to move back into their room tomorrow. And again, campus police have arranged for counselors to be brought on site for any students who want to talk to them. But for now, the situation here is slowly returning to normal as the Sacramento police assume the lead in this investigation. Live at Sac State, I'm Kevin Riggs, KCRA 3 reports.